Let me tell you something about this whole fire. You may not play in many of concerts. Good city, because we're not playing in Boston, Cleveland, St. Troy, and Brooklyn. But while I was in St. Troy, something happened. I went to a place called the Key Beach to swim. While I was there, I heard God was passing. I said to myself, if only I could touch his end, and I know that I would never be the same again. But listen to me, please, something deep within. Keep on reminding me of my sins. So I stretch and I stretch, but I could not reach him. So I knock and I knock, but still could not reach him. But then I remember Matthew 7 verse 7. Then knock on the door, it shall be open. God come up from this old violin. Brush him off, fix him up, and give him some new strength. Replace my tongue and give me new song to sing. After the sea, God bury my sins. Wash me in the blood that make me whole again. For the rest of my life, I plan to serve him. From the rising of the sun to the ground, I'm not the same. I'm ready to end the end. Start all over again, even then, my friend. I said, Lord, why would you save a wretched sinner like me? Just in case you forget who I am, Lord, let me remind you. I said, Lord, I am a drug dealer, a ganja smoker, liquor drinker, evil thinker, womanizer, pandemizer, heartbreaker, bottom lover, totem lover, winner fighter, liar, gambler, player, aker, fornicator, woman eater, anarchist, warmonger. So how could this be, but God says, son, I am the Alpha and Omega, I'm with all the trouble. Then we hear about a little church in Maryland, on Baltimore Avenue and Route 1, with a Guyanese pastor named Pastor O'Brien. One Sunday, me go listen to the sermon. One Sunday to be in that congregation, the pastor preach about lust and fornication. Who in my married don't live a husband woman? Who a come a church and living in Babylon? Me say, me nah go back, cause me no like a winter. Me know say I'm in him a true immortal. On the next Sunday, congregation, second Sunday, sitting on the congregation, but now I'm born again, and I'm broken of it. I'm only coughing at the devil, and I'm not born, there is one thing I want to clear up tonight. That word Thanksgiving, we're not using it right. Church, we thank God when he moved. The real miracle is to thank God before he moves. And when you start thanking him for the invisible, then you can do the impossible. And you can possess the intangible. When you pray for your husband to put down the bomb, thank him as if it's already done. When you pray for your son to leave the drugs and the gun, thank him as if it's already done.
I never could make. us to God for that tonight. Is it God? You would never have made it, Sister Jane. Trust me, the devil been after us so many times, but we escape him. Amen? Please put your hands together and welcome as Bishop Clark will come and do the community award, and he's going to be accompanied by Sister Robinson. Please put your hands together for Bishop Clark as he comes.
Understand how we were able to get to the decision of who to receive these awards. We sent out requests and so many members from the congregations responded. If you don't mind, let me go ahead and read some of the emails we received. This email said, my pastor deserves the award because he will come to your home in the middle of the night. He will give you his last dollar. He will give you the last meal on his plate. He will give you anything, including the shirt on his back. He will never say no to you. He will never look down at you. He always have a word to encourage you, even when he needs a word. This one is near and dear to my heart, because I know what you're talking about. I know a man that you could go to in the middle of the night. His phone is never turned off. He doesn't have a time when you cannot call him. He doesn't have rest day. He doesn't have downtime. Anytime you need him, I am a witness. He has an open door. And so I'm proud today to offer an outstanding, dedicated, outstanding citizen award and community servant award to none other than Dr. Anthony Connor. This is just a small token of our appreciation. Words cannot express what you mean to me and to all those who lay at your feet. This says the ACGMA presents to Dr. Anthony Blackwood, the 2011 Outstanding Servant and Scholar of the Living God Community Service Award. Thank you for your service. Thank you for your commitment to the body of Christ.
Fellowship and Kingdom Link and all those who have been having any form of input to this occasion. Thank you so very much. And our Christian Center stands here to just say we are in the ministry to bless and to be a blessing. God bless you.
I tried to get out of this valley. I told him I refused to give Dr. Blackwood anything. I told him I didn't want to do it with Dr. Blackwood. They forced me out. But they go home with Molly Molly. We need Christian fellowship. So we're the only church with a Molly Molly pastor. Like Jeremiah. A weeping prophet. The Lord have mercy. One of our nominees is not here today, but he also is a man that continues to open his door, his arms, and everything that he owns to the work and the commitment and the dedication to the body of Christ. None other than one of our very own, our beloved dear friend and brother, Dr. Warren Dillon. Come on, put your hands together. He's not here today, but we want to recognize him. Thank you so much. God bless.